In true banger spirit, we present to you a new show, How to Get Into, where we attempt to get new fans into some of metal's most extreme genres. And what better way to start it than by demystifying the mystic world of black metal. There are a lot of genres contained within metal, but the one you're likely to hear about before you actually hear is black metal. It's got that core that outsiders think all metal's about.
Satan.
And that's provided endless fascination for looky-loos and even Hollywood. But when the people who hear about the music actually hear the music, they can be a little turned off. And not without reason. Many of the genre's hallmarks are extremely grating to new listeners. Some might be content to keep this genre walled off, but that's not the banger way. We're all about spreading our love for metal and bringing as many people into the flock as we can. And hey, if you're already a fan of black metal, let us know in the comments below what band got you into the genre, and is there a genre that you think more people need to get into? So the first question we must answer is, what is black metal? And in true black metal fashion, it's confusing and difficult because there's not one, there's two black metals. The first wave of black metal was pioneered by Venom. Casting a spell, leather and hell, black metal gods rock and roll. But when you're hearing people talk about black metal, you're probably hearing about the second wave, pioneered in Norway in the 90s. It's a genre that was influenced by the rise of death metal, which is a genre that was influenced by the first wave of black metal. Hey, confusing. Basically, a bunch of Norwegian kids got mad that death metal was taken by the record industry and commercialized and overproduced. So, what were these Norwegian kids to do? Well, a couple of murders, a few church burnings, and like many emerging underground scenes before them, try and make wholly unlistenable music. The low growls of death metal were replaced with high-pained shrieks. Guitars and drums were set to always on with tremolo picking and blast beats. Bassists, get out of here, we don't want you, take a hike. Record that all on a Fisher-Price tape player in someone's basement and season with a dash of
Satan.
And whoops, we accidentally made some masterpieces that will live forever in the genre, like Dark Throne's Ablaze in the Northern Sky. But, like many of life's finest things, scotch, truffles, blue cheese, if you're not already a fan, it can come off harsh, unpleasant, and in the case of seeing Watain live, quite pungent. So, how do you get to enjoying that unique flavor? How do you get your spouse, your kid, your dad on Team Black Metal? Well, by playing them black metal, of course. No, not that black metal, the other black metal. Black metal. Lay down your soul to the gods, rock and roll. Yeah, the first one, there we go. So, after we got the second wave of black metal, we sort of got the second wave of the first wave of black metal in a genre we now call black and roll. It's a great first time listen because it takes the fun, cool atmosphere of black metal and drapes it over the skeleton of some quality rock and roll music. And as a bonus, unlike a lot of beginner genres, ways to dip your toe into the pool, it's not shunned by genre purists. You're not gonna have someone looking down on you for enjoying black and roll. They probably enjoy it as much as you just did. That's a great quality. Basically, think black metal with a little less
Satan
and a little more fun at parties. There's a bunch of great examples of bands doing this, from early albums by Norway's Kvelertak to pretty much anything by Cleveland's Midnight. But if you wanna know one of the best doing it that you might not have heard about yet, it's Scotland's Hellripper. And like all good black metal music, it's made by one guy at home alone under a blanket. If you wanna get into black metal, get used to that. Let's listen to a clip. It's Hell's Rock and Roll. Hey, that title is almost exactly like the genre description I gave. Convenient. Okay, Okay, so maybe you've been listening to a bit of black metal and you want to get a little further into it. Or maybe you hate beer and black and roll then just really isn't for you. Well, let's dive even further into every metalhead's favorite topic, subgenres. Of course, one of the nerdiest genres in metal is gonna have a whole hell of a lot of subgenres. A great one for new and old fans alike, and how I personally got into the genre, is atmospheric black metal. Atmospheric black metal sounds like someone played a black metal record, recorded it poorly, put it on a new record, and sold it to you again. There's a layer of air between yourself and the music that can help blunt some of the sharper parts of black metal and make it a very relaxing genre. Also, there's less anger and more sadness. So if that aggression was scaring you off, well, let's put on a record and have a nice cry. Some examples, Blut aus Nords, Memoria Vetusta series, all that music by that racist vlogger we don't talk about. And for my money, it doesn't get much better than Nun's Damp Chill of Life. Have a listen, you'll see what I mean. It has all the hallmarks of great black metal, mysterious band members, winter, but with atmospheric stretches that could appeal to fans of bands outside of metal, like Explosions in the Sky or Godspeed You Black Emperor, which is useful if you're wondering how to get into black metal. Hey, look, I did it. Full circle, baby. Hey, if this wasn't a pilot, I'd give you two more subgenres, but it is, so bye.